Hard for me to call you Dr. Isaac. I want to say Marissa all the time. Dr. Marissa, how about that? reducing stress with mothers and children is something that you've kind of dove into quite a bit, had a lot of experience in. Talk to us about what you've done in your practice with stress and as it relates to women and children.
Sure. So I'm going to tell you all a little bit about a day in what my practice might have looked like. Years ago, I was doing stress tests of patients. I was actually doing brainwave testing of patients. And I had a large percentage of my patient base who was either pregnant or trying to get pregnant. And I was shocked to find the number of women who had a stress response on this test that exactly resembled that of guys who had been in the special forces defusing incendiary bombs in hostile countries. That's how stressed these women were. And so I started doing research looking at the outcome of that kind of stress on an unborn child. And what I discovered was that those babies are often born with a lower threshold for stress, meaning that it takes far less to stress those children out. At the same time, I was seeing a really high percentage of young kids who were showing clear signs of anxiousness or emotional issues, sometimes from as early as 3 years of age. By school age, those same kids were being investigated for behavioral issues and focus and concentration and mental health challenges. And as I looked at these kids, the vast majority of them had had multiple health issues from a very early age, and they'd gone through numerous conventional treatments. And what was happening there was that nobody was advising those parents to look at those children's gut health afterwards. And so after medication and after illness, nobody was connecting the dots for parents between nutrition and gut health and brain health. And then, of course, I had the teens. And every time a new 14 or 15-year-old girl came into my practice, I knew what she was coming in for. The severity of the anxiousness and the sadness that teens are experiencing these days is incredible. And the number of days that they're losing from school because of those issues is tremendous. And so, I want to ask you, how many of you can recognize someone you know in that picture? How many of you might even have lived part of that picture? We're seeing these issues in every health practice across North America and around the world. And I want you to stop and consider the power that we have with doTERRA, with our supplements and our oils, to bring profound relief and to shift the experience that families are having in their homes. At the beginning of my journey with doTERRA, this was my why. It continues to be the reason why I believe that every single home needs doTERRA essential oils and supplements. So as you head home this week, I want you to ask yourself every single day, whose life can I bring some hope or promise to today?